All right, over the last few lectures, we've developed the weak form and the finite element model for this kind of generic standard PDE. And I gave you some examples to show you that this one PDE or this generic example could solve quite a few different types of problems in mechanics and fluid mechanics and otherwise. And also gave you a homework assignment to write a general 1D finite element code for this problem. Today, in kind of a way to help you a little bit with your homework, I'm going to work an example. I'm going to actually write a little bit of code in this video, but only for a special case. And I'm not going to do the homework for you. I'm not going to write a generic 1D finite element code like I asked you to do. I'm going to write it for this specific kind of special case problem. And I'm also going to write it in a way that's not exactly the way you'd write a code for general purpose for, say, any node spacing or, you know, any number of degrees of freedom. We're going to kind of specialize it and work through just step by step. So for this example, the special case for our model problem is going to be when A equals to 1, C equals to minus 1, F equals to minus x squared. So then our model equation becomes du squared dx squared minus u plus x squared equal to 0. The domain is going to be from 0 to 1 with the essential boundary conditions that u at 0 is equal to 0 and u at 1 is equal to 0. And so we already know that we can just write down our element stiffness matrix that goes from XA to XB, where XA and XB are the nodal endpoints of an element. The NIs are the element shape functions. So that's what the stiffness matrix would be for this problem. And the nodal force vector would look like this. Okay. And so for this problem, we're going to consider just four elements. Four elements: element 1, element 2, element 3, element 4, and it's going to be node number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And they're going to be equally spaced, so the distance in between them is going to be 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, and 1/4. Okay, and so with that, I'm going to switch over and I'll write a little bit of code to show you how you might solve this problem for you at the nodes. And we're going to restrict ourselves to linear elements here. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is write a function that will actually construct the shape functions for us, given two nodal positions. So I'll call it n function. And it's going to take XA and XB as arguments. And I mean, we're just using linear shape functions, so they're certainly easy enough to just write them down. But we'll go ahead for completeness and show you how you can make them, right? Just once again. So when we construct the so-called A matrix, we're going to evaluate the vector x at xA, and then again at xB, and then this function will return x dot inverse A. And our local variables are going to be x and a, and these should be arguments. So if we look at what our this guy does. So for, say, the first element, we have XA is 0, and first element XA is 0, and XB is 1/4. Then we have this, okay? So again, I'm not gonna write this in a really clever way. I'm just gonna sort of say that the shape functions for element one, I'm gonna call this function 4 times. Of course, if you're writing a real program, you'd basically put this in a loop of some sort. I'm just gonna be very explicit here. So the second element has endpoints 1/4 and 1/2. The third element has endpoints 1/2 and 3/4. And the last element has endpoints 3/4 and 1, right? So there's our 4 sets of shape functions. So there's 2 shape functions per element, of course. Okay? And so with that, I think we can construct our first element stiffness matrix. So the stiffness matrix for element 1 is going to be equal to the integral from xA to xB. So that's 0 to 1/4. We're going to take the derivative of the element shape function 1. And remember, there's actually 2 shape functions there. So we're going to take the ith one with respect to x. Then we're going to take the jth one with respect to x. And then we're going to take not the derivative, but just the shape function itself, the ith one multiplied by the jth one. And we're going to integrate with respect to x. Something's not quite right. There we go. All right. And then we need to create a matrix. So we're going to iterate over I from 1 to 2 and J from 1 to 2. And so there's our first element stiffness matrix. And we're just going to sort of do the same thing. Again, this is not the way you would write a general purpose program. But here we're going to go from 1/4 to 1/2. And everything else will be the same, except we're going to use element 2 shape functions. And likewise for 3, we'll go from 1/2 to 3/4 over element 3's 2 shape functions. Finally, element 4 will go from 3/4 to 1. Okay, and we'll go ahead and execute all these. And lo and behold, the stiffness matrix are the same as they actually should be, because the elements are all of the same length and the data is constant over the entire body. So that's a good sign. Okay, so now we need to assemble these element stiffness matrices into a global stiffness matrix. So we're gonna start with just allocating a constant array that's 5 by 5, right? So that's just a 5 by 5 matrix of zeros, 5 by 5 because there's 5 nodes. And then I'm going to basically put in the 1, 2 block, KE1, and the 2, 3 block, KE2. Notice I used the plus equals. That means I'm going to add it to whatever is there. So in the 3, 4 block, KE3, and the 4, 5 block, KE4. Right, and so that printed out all of the individuals there, but if we look at the end, what the global K looks like, we see there's our stiffness matrix. Okay, so now we need to do the nodal forces. Again, we'll start with a constant array of zeros. This time it's just a vector, so we'll just have 5 of those. And this time I'll just go ahead and put them in on the fly. So in the 1, 1 block, we have the integral from 0 to 1/4 minus x squared times NE1 I. over x, and we need to iterate over all the shape functions, so we have a table that goes from I from 1 to 2. Alright, and then we'll just repeat this. So from 2 to 3, we have 1/4 to 1/2. So this is the second element. And we're going to go from 3 to 4 which is 1/2 to 3/4. This is the third element. From 4 to 5 goes from 3/4 to 1, and this is the fourth element. Okay, so now if we look at what F is, okay, you see it's there, so I'll go ahead and leave that like that. Okay, so we have K, the global stiffness matrix, and we have the right-hand side vector F, but we can't solve this. We know K is singular, so we need to apply the boundary conditions. And if you remember, the boundary conditions were essential boundary conditions that at U is 1, at U is 1, we have U of 0 is equal to 0, and U at 1 is equal to 0. So that basically means that each end of the at each end of the bar, the U is zero, okay? So that means that the first and the last row and column of the stiffness matrix should be zeroed out except for one on the diagonal. So there's a couple of ways we could do that. One is we might just create a constant array. Actually, I think it's easy enough just in this case to just say the 1-1 entry of the global stiffness matrix is equal to 1. And we have to zero the other ones out, so the 1-2 is equal to 0. Likewise, the 2-1 is equal to 0. That'll take care of the first row and first column. So then the last row, 5-5, is equal to 1. And 5-4 is equal to 0. And 4-5 is equal to 0. And same thing on F, we need to say that F 1 is equal to 0 and F 5 is equal to 0. And so if we do that and then we take a look at what K and F are. Okay, now we've applied the boundary conditions, so we should be able to solve this. So we just say U is equal to linear solve KF. And so that's the solution. So again, this is obviously not a proper program. This is not how you program up a generic case, but this gives you an idea of how you might tackle, you know, each of the individual steps. So we constructed each element stiffness matrix. We assembled them into the global stiffness matrix. We constructed the right-hand side vector. We applied the boundary conditions. And then we solved the problem. Okay? So with that, we're going to move on.